I'm Tony McDonough. I'm a legal director in the shipping team at Hill Dickinson. And I'm here today to talk to you about a recent success we had in the case called Mr. Stephen Meek against BP Shipping. Why do we think it's important? Well, it's a personal injury claim on board a ship, and claimant solicitors routinely issue these proceedings in the county court, where the court rules are quite clear that they should issue the proceedings in the Admiralty Court. What often happens is that they bring proceedings against shipowner defendants together with land-based defendants, and what the court does is it takes the view that the shipowner defendants are necessary parties to the action, and they proceed on that basis. Details of the claim are that Mr. Meek was serving on board ships owned by BP Shipping and Fife Shipping between 1974 and 1979. He alleged that he was exposed to excessive noise and that he suffered a hearing deficit as a result. What was unusual about this particular case was that the defendants were both ship owners. There were no land-based defendants in this matter. And accordingly, from the outset, we pleaded Section 20 of the Senior Courts Act and Part 61 of the Civil Procedure Rules. Effectively, both these provisions provide that where there's a personal injury on board a ship, the claim must be brought in the Admiralty Court. There's no doubt about this. It must be issued in the Admiralty Court. We thought that would be the end of it, but the claimant solicitors and the claimant carried on, and in fact we ended up making a strikeout application. Now, at the hearing of the strikeout application, the claimant's counsel made three objections to our application. He said, one, that the personal injury that Mr. Meek was complaining about didn't fall within the meaning of Section 20 of the Senior Courts Act. Two, he said that if we were going to contest jurisdiction, we ought to have made an application under CPR Part 11 shortly after the proceedings were served. And three, he said that a strikeout of the claim would be too draconian, and that what the court ought to do is make an order under its case management powers under CPR Part 3 and to transfer the case from the county court back into the Admiralty Court. We objected to all of these arguments, and fortunately the judge was with us on this occasion. In relation to the first point, he said that this was clearly an injury which occurred on board a ship, and it was fairly and squarely within Section 20 of the Senior Courts Act. In relation to the Part 11 application point, he said that that was related to cases where there was a debate about the jurisdiction, and this was a case where there was no jurisdiction whatever. And similarly, in relation to the question about whether the court should transfer back to the Admiralty Court, he said that the court simply had no jurisdiction. The case had been wrongly issued. Jurisdiction wasn't there for the county court to do anything except for strike out the case. So it was a good outcome for us and for our clients. We think it's important because it's another tool in the defendant's armoury. And so where you have cases where that land-based defendant ingredient is missing, this is a useful case. It doesn't have binding authority, but it's persuasive, and we look forward to using these arguments again in the future.